Hi, Jim Shaw here from Crystal Group. We're taking a little bit deeper dive again into MIL-STD-810. Today we're talking a little bit about method 512, which is immersion. Method 512 talks about, essentially it has two procedures. One's immersion and one's fording. And so method 512 is different than an IP rating. That's a separate spec. But you can kind of make some parallels between immersion protection, like IP67, versus the immersion specification and testing that you do in MIL-STD-810 method 512. So what is the test method for 810? So method 512 talks about essentially immersion to say 1 meter, for a period of time of 30 minutes, so it kind of lines up fairly well with IP67, but in that case, it's really talking about the sealing of the box, the connectorization, making sure that you don't have leakage or damage in the system. And that's usually just a temporary 30-minute test. The fording requirement, which is this procedure two, that's a little bit different because that talks about partial immersion, it talks about total immersion, and the depths can go up. So one is intended to be for equipment that might see some water damage. The other one is intended for equipment that would be mounted in something like an MRAP or a striker that would be flooded occasionally and actually fording through waterways. And the way that you go about that in terms of designing the equipment is a very different approach. You can see here we've got one of our standard carbon fiber units. It's air over components design, whereas that obviously would not bode well for an immersion type of an environment. While it's conformal coated, it probably just isn't going to live. Whereas our SE16 here, which is rated to the immersion spec, that is much more capable of withstanding sustained submersion in an environment for a length of extended period of time with no issues, because we're using the right kind of connectors and the sealing, the gasketing that's necessary to keep the water out of the system for full operation under those conditions. So again, the basic differences between the two procedures in method 512 is the immersion testing intends to be equipment that could be subjected to leakage or dripping or that kind of things, whereas the fording requirement is material that's intended to be driven through or submerged for an extended period of time. So those are the basic differences. When you read the specification, you can vet that out based on which application or which requirements you're actually have been levied on you. So I hope that's useful. Thanks.
Join us next time for another shiny object at Crystal Group.